Hello and welcome to this new tutorial on my channel. Today we are going to be messing around with the slash script command. And today we are in the Phenium world. It's like a project I worked on, but I didn't really, well, continue to work on. I don't know why, but this world is perfect to test because it has some game tests in it, which we can use to show the script command. And when we try to type in script, we can see two options, one being the debugger, the other one being a profiler, right? And we are going to be looking at the debugger first, right? And for that, you want to have the Minecraft Bedrock Edition debugger extension. You can just download it from Visual Studio Code extension marketplace, and you need to copy this command. I will paste it down into this description, right? Then you need to open a workspace folder, right? You can open folder, then just whatever your workspace is, right? Then you need to open a terminal, a PowerShell, and then you have to paste in the command, and then it says okay. If you don't want to do it in Visual Studio Code, you can always just open in terminal, a new PowerShell, and just type in the same thing. What this will do is it will allow us to connect to ourselves, basically. It will enable the loopback thingy. So yeah, it allows us to connect to ourselves, if you can say so. Right, I already have this, I'm just going to delete it. Right. Now when we try to click on the run and debug page, right, then we can create a launcher.json file or click on run and debug. Most people click on run and debug, I'm gonna do it too. So I will choose the Minecraft debugger, and then I'm gonna enter a port, 19144, it's the default port, or the recommended port, right. Now it will say in the debug console that it's trying to connect, but it will fail because the launch.json is wrong. We need to edit it, right? This is the launch.json. So first of all, we don't need a host. And second of all, the mode shouldn't be connect. It should be listen, right? And now we can actually start the debugger. As you can see, our thingy turned yellow. And now we can connect to our debugger. If you type in debugger, connect, and then your IP, and because we are on the same computer, we can just type localhost, and then the port we set the debugger to, in this case 19144, which should be always the port for it. And then we can set breakpoints in our scripts. Breakpoints are basically points where the script basically just stops. By the way, please don't judge my code. This was like my very first thing I wrote, okay? So if you look at this, please don't be ashamed of me, okay? Yeah, so we can actually, let me format it. We can actually set breakpoints to and stop Minecraft from running and see what code is being run on that point. Like for example, we can set a breakpoint at for const player of players, like here. And because this is a tick, this will break. So the breakpoints will stop Minecraft whenever the script is being run on this position, right? So because this is a tick function, it will stop on this point every tick, right? If you click on continue, it will stop again because it's every tick. And now you can actually hover over things to see what they are. Like for example, the player. We can see it's an object, and we can see all properties or whatever from the player. We can see the name, we can see the selected slot, basically everything what the player can or has to, or what generally a player object can do. But of course, you can do more things with it. Like for example, if you have like a variable that you need to check, right? For example, what is bonus mana? We don't know what bonus mana is, we just hover over it, and then we can see zero. Or bonus mana gain, it's also zero, right? We can hover over variables to see what they are. This doesn't really make sense, but yeah. So, if player has tech, we can also look. If we try to hover it, it will just say function because it's like kinda hidden, right? And yeah, so with that we can like look over things and see what they are. Like for example, players, right? And we can also see, look in into objects from the player object. And this is just generally very useful for debugging. And yeah, when you're done, you can just remove the breakpoints and continue. The game will, you know, go on as normal. Right? Or does it actually? Yeah, I think it does. But I will show it again to you when it breaks. Minecraft is basically frozen, right? You can't open inventory. You see my mana bar went gone. You can't, like, go through a portal, right? Minecraft is basically frozen at that state. Right? And when we click next, everything just, well, happens. Okay. Now for the second thing, I will disconnect the debugger. And for the second thing, it's gonna be the profiler. The profiler. So we can type script profiler and then start to start a profiler. And then we can do stuff like, I don't know, type something in the chat or anything related to a script, right? Then we can stop it when we're done with our work. You will see what it does. It will write a CPU profile file to our logs. So we first have to get to our logs. It's not in the com Mojang folder. It's in the local state folder, actually. Then you have a logs ordner with all your content logs. But there's also a folder called profiles. And in those profiles, we can see, well, our profiles, right? What things we have done. So we can open those profiles in either Visual Studio Code or in Chrome. They might be sometimes buggy because of some functions, but I don't know. Mojang, or they said they're working on a fix. And now if I copy it here, you can see a list with every time measurement for the actual script. So we can see that the mana system took well, a lot of time in the profiler, right? While things like some iterators or whatever this is just takes no time, right? We can see what takes the most time, what probably produces lag, right? And this is just a general performance measurement, right? So you can view what things you need to change. It's like Watchdog, but it actually tells you where the problem is, right? As you can see here, we can just go into that file, we can just click on it, and we can change stuff if we want to do that. But yeah, that's actually it. I mean, there are some more options to the debugger, right? Like there's not only connect, there's listen, there's close, whatever. But you usually don't need those. So yeah, that's basically it. Pretty useful if you ask me. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you want to see more of those type of videos, then please like and subscribe. And check out my other videos. And please leave a comment what I should do for Skylandia. The top comment will be actually... I will use the top comment and make the top comment into like an actual item or something. Whatever you wrote, right? So yeah, please leave down your suggestions down in the comments. And bye!